Hello, AP students. This is Mrs. Politsky, and I have notes for Chapter 9, Psychological Development, Part 4. And we're going to talk about cognitive development to start with. Jean Piaget, who you see pictured to the right. Piaget spent over 50 years observing intellectual development of children by posing problems for them to solve. He looked at development transitions and changes in thinking, reasoning, and problem solving, or as we would call cognitive development. And Piaget had basically four stages: the sensory motor, which basically is from birth to about age two, pre-operational, which is kind of like your toddler years from about age two to about age six, concrete operational from age 7 to 11, which is kind of like your primary school grades. And finally, formal operations, which starts roughly about the time of puberty and goes throughout adulthood. So as we go along here, we're going to talk a little bit about some of these. We may spend a little more time talking about formal operations a little later. So let's take a look here at our chart. I mentioned before, there are some different characteristics that happen at each stage. When we talk about sensory motor, we're talking about how young people will experience things through their senses. Pre-operational is we're learning things like language, symbols, numbers. Concrete operational, you're learning principles of conservation, reversibility, serial ordering. And then finally, formal operations is when we get into this idea of abstract thinking, deductive reasoning, and such. So a while back, we talked a little bit about the fact that when we are looking at development, sometimes it's not always in a continuous fashion. So there are discontinuous stages when we talk about the model of development, and which Piaget emphasized that children undergo a revolution in thought at basically each stage. Ideas like schemas are for the most part mental structures that guide our thinking. They are the building blocks of thinking, and these form and change as we develop and organize our knowledge to deal with experiences and to predict future events. Assimilation is a mental process that modifies new information to fit into the existing schemas. So it makes new information fit the existing view of the world. And accommodation, this is the mental processes that restructures existing schemas so that new information is better understood, such as the changing our view to fit the new info. So the sensory motor stages is from birth to two. The child relies heavily on innate motor responses to stimuli. It's reflexive. It is instinctive. So mental representations, the ability to form internal images of objects and events starts occurring here. We have one of our big features of object permanence. This is the knowledge that objects exist independently of one's own actions and awareness. One of the greatest ways to kind of test this is a game of peekaboo. Typically, when infants think that maybe their caregiver has left the room, they have a tendency to get a little anxious. But usually by about 18 months, they kind of figure out how this game works. And so they may do things like take a blanket and cover their head. And the idea is that you can't see me, hence I have disappeared. And they kind of catch on to how that all works. So in the sensory motor stage, reflexive schemas, newborn reflexes, that's kind of the first thing that happens. There's primary circular reactions, simple motor habits, basically centering on the body. Secondary circular reactions, this is repeated interesting effects in the surroundings so that they might be responding to that. And then as we go along, there's intentional goal-oriented behavior, such as the object permanence. And finally, you get into the exploring properties of objects, picking up something and looking at it and manipulating it. All right. The pre-operational stage. This is from ages 2 to about 6. This is the emergence of the self as a distinctive from other people and objects in the environment. Well-developed mental representations, use of language, and they can solve simple problems. Children at this stage tend to be a little more egocentric, and you might see self-centered behavior, the inability to realize that there are other people's viewpoints aside from their own. So there's a tendency to be, it's my way or the highway kind of thought when we deal with toddlers. The child can see the world in terms of themselves. So it's always kind of a me first at this point in life. Animistic thinking. This is the mode of thought in which inanimate objects kind of take on a life of their own. They're imagined to have a life or to have mental processes. So think about it maybe in the terms of Christopher Robbins and his menagerie of stuffed animals. Pooh Bear kind of has a life of his own. And that's part of that animistic thinking. Centration, this is the thought pattern involving the inability to take into account more than one factor at a time. And irreversibility, this is the inability to think through a series of events or mental operations and then mentally reverse these steps. So when you talk about things like addition and subtraction, a child who's kind of going through this pre-operational stage might struggle a little bit with this, though, you know, concepts of addition, you know, you can start building those really even at age 2. It's the deducting that might take a little bit more time for them to kind of grasp. So an example of kind of like reversibility, and some of this is kind of moving into our next step when we talk about conservation, but this idea that I could take 2 beakers of like fluids and pour it into a taller beaker, and they might not realize that it's the same amount of fluid, even though it is the same amount of fluid. So moving on. Concrete operational, this is from about age 7 to 11. It's the third stage. A child will understand conservation, but still is incapable of abstract thought. Conservation is the understanding that physical properties of an object or substance don't change when the appearance changes. So like the beakers that we were looking at just a second ago, but nothing is added or taken away. So if I change the bowl to a tall slender cylinder, and I put the same amount of fluid in, they might have a hard time before this stage. By the time we get to concrete operational, they start grasping those ideas. Mental operations, solving problems by manipulating images in one's own mind, they start grasping this. Using the ability to perform mental operations, a child will begin to use simple reasoning to solve problems. So if we take a look at some conservation tasks, you know, they have the coins, you might see the pennies here that are all kind of laid out. If I change the spacing of that, you might actually fool someone. You know, and early on in this concrete operational stage, truth is it's all the same. Mass, I can take 2 lumps of clay, I can take 1, leave it as a lump, take the other, roll it out. You would know that both lumps of clay are the same volume. We've mentioned how the fluid in the glass, weight, same idea. A pound of rocks versus a pound of feathers. Even though you might think one is heavier than another, they're both a pound. All right. Thank you very much.